and is joined by his parents, Vinny Krishnalone, a four-year varsity player. He will be attending Indian River State College on a baseball scholarship, following in the footsteps of his father, Vinny, and our head coach, Ralph Henriquez. Please welcome Nathan Barroso. Nathan's joined by his parents, Brian and Nicole Barroso, a two-year varsity player. Nathan, this fall, will be attending the Florida State University. Nathan Barroso. Please welcome Tom Besson. Tom is joined by his parents, Sean and Julia Besson. A four-year varsity player, Tom this fall will also be attending the Florida State University. Tom Besson. Please welcome Jaden Birchfield. Jaden is joined by his parents, Gary and Debbie Birchfield. Jaden has played varsity ball for 2 years. He'll be studying this fall civil and construction engineering. Jaden Birchfield. Please welcome Daniel Barbella. Daniel's joined by his parents, Freddie and Sherry Barbella. A two-year varsity player, Daniel will be attending the University of Central Florida this fall. Daniel Barbella. Please welcome Michael Alfonso. Michael is joined by his parents, Antonio and Sarah Alfonso. A four-year varsity player, Michael this fall will be attending Indian River State College on a baseball scholarship. Michael Alfonso. Ladies and gentlemen, let's celebrate the 2021 Conk Baseball Seniors. Ladies and gentlemen, here are tonight's starting lineups for the visiting Warriors from Westminster Christian High School. Leading off, the third baseman, number 4, Sal Stewart. Batting second is catching, number 14, Jaden Melendez. Batting third and playing shortstop, wearing jersey number 1, Rene Ramirez. Batting fourth, the designated hitter, number 23, Rainier Benitez. Batting fifth, playing first base, number 12, D'Angelo Ortiz. Batting sixth, the center fielder, wearing jersey number 24, Alan George. Batting seventh, the second baseman, number 30, Christian Mosquet. Batting eighth, right fielder, number 9, Luis Ueha. And batting ninth, left fielder, number 18, Christian Ueha. Pitching tonight, number 22, is Joel Pinheiro. Also in uniform tonight, number 2, Julian Hernandez. Number 5, Derek Tagle. Number 6, Greg Penton. Number 7, Chase Campbell. Number 16, Sebastian Gonzalez. Number 17, Willie Alvarez. Number 19, Peter Frometta. Number 21, Luis Castano. Number 25, Jake Suarez. Number 28, Hunter Rebhan. Number 29, Danny Hernandez, and number 32, Logan Lopez. The coaching staff, assistants, Dax Gallegos, Billy Comber, Joel Pinheiro, and the head coach, Emil Castellanos. Ladies and gentlemen, the Warriors from Westminster Christian High School. Key West High School, leading off, center fielder, number one, Spike Pellissier. Batting second and playing left field, number four, Landon Lowe. Batting third and catching, wearing jersey number 19, Daniel Varela. Batting fourth, third baseman, number 10, Preston Hurst. Batting fifth, playing right field, number 22, Jayden Birchfield. Batting sixth, the first baseman, number 24, Trevor Zelch. Batting seventh, second baseman, number 14, Wyatt Hume. Batting eighth, the designated hitter, number six, Nathan Barroso. Batting ninth, the shortstop, number three, Kai Smith. On the mound tonight, wearing jersey number 28, Michael Alfonso. Also in uniform tonight for the Cubs, number 25, Lucky Barroso. Number 12, Tom Bessie. Number 21, Jacob Burnham. Number 9, Jack Haggard. Number 8, Billy Kite. Number 18, Anthony Larin. Number 27, Andon Rady. Number 11, Gabe Williams. Number 30, Jason Yarbrough. Number 29, Ja'Kai Blake. And number 31, Felix Ong. The coaching staff, assistants, Dexter Butler, Drew Haggard, Ralphie Henriquez, and your head coach, the winningest coach in the history of Key West High School baseball, Ralph Henriquez. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise. Remove your ball caps and sing along as we honor America with the playing of our national anthem.
Where's a guy in street clothes covered in dirt, just a rock and roll t-shirt, headed to work with a pack of red man in his pocket. He's kind of red man, but he's rocking. Where's a beat up Timmy and a Marshall stack, little Marshall Tupper and a six pack. Where's a good old boys and a good old day, straight up getting sideways. We back in the speakers, back in black, getting blasted in the bleachers. It's probably true what my mama said, I do it just like my daddy did. We back in the saddle, back on stage, making the whole place rattle. Back with the beat, take a train on the track. Don't we
your Key West battery tonight behind the plate. Number 19, Daniel Varela, and on the mound, number 28, Michael Alfonso. The Warriors in the top half of the first inning. Third baseman number 4, Sal Stewart. Catcher, number 14, Jaden Melendez. Shortstop, number 1, Rene Ramirez. For the Warriors in the top half of the first inning, no runs, no hits, no errors. It was 3 up and 3 down. The score after one half inning of play, Westminster nothing. Your Fighting Cox coming to bat.
Strapped
off for the Conks in the bottom half of the first inning. Center fielder, number one, Spike Pellicino. Left fielder, number four, Landon Lowe. Now batting, the catcher, wearing jersey number 19, Daniel Varela, 19.
In safely. Allowed 26 runs, in which only 13 have been earned. This ball is hit hard, but foul down the third baseline for strike two. It remains one ball and two strikes on the foul ball. He struck out 43 to those 12 walks. So he's good. He's their number one guy. So it's a battle of the number ones here tonight at the Rex. Count remains one ball and two strikes here to Varela. A big wide stance from the right-hand side. Daniel awaits the big, slow, looping, breaking ball. Swings through it. He'll strike him out. So first strikeout for Pinheiro.
Now batting.
There's now two away for Preston Hurst, who just about as great a play as you can make in a tight situation in the bottom of the seventh yesterday with that backhanded stab. After the home run was hit to get them within two runs, they had a runner over at first base yesterday, but he made that great stab and got that force out over at second base. So coming off a terrific game defensively yesterday was Hurst. He also had a couple of hits and he worked out a walk yesterday. He awaits the 0-1, pitches outside for a ball to throw down to second from the catcher Melendez, sails out into center field, but Lando will hold up over at second base after he steals the bag. Below, that's his eighth stolen base of the year. Count one ball and one strike to Preston. Now got his average at 237. Leads the team in runs scored with 20. He's got eight ribbies. He's got a home run as well. He's worked out 15 walks and leads the team in that crazy category, hit by pitch. He's been plunked 12 times. One shy away from the school record. Also leads the team in stolen bases with 10, but right now he's in the hole, one ball and two strikes. Two away, Conks have a runner in scoring position. Hurst took rather nicely to this four hole yesterday. See what he can do here with the 1-2. He'll swing on it and pop it up over on the first base side in foul territory. The catcher Melendez looking at it, but he runs out of room and it lands into the crowd right in front of myself and Judd here in the Todd Swofford Broadcast Pavilion. Let's set that Westminster Christian Warriors defense. Jaden Melendez behind the plate. D'Angelo Ortiz is over at first. Christian Bosquez is at second. Sal Stewart, the third baseman. Manny Ramirez is the shortstop. Christian Mejia in left. Alan George in center. And Luis Mejia in right field. The 1-2. Swing on and fouled out of play again by Preston. And the count remains at 1-2. So, Judd, I think this is the first time this year that we've seen the same exact lineup back-to-back games.
I agree with you, Rich, yeah.
1-2. Low over at second with two away. The pitch to Hurst. Oh, that was just a bit outside. Boy, that was close to take on that one, Judd. Woo. We get the call, though. This is outside. Pinero's got that good breaking ball, and he can really drop the speed down on it. Preston got the call, ball two. 2-2. Again, tries to break the ball, and this one pops up a little bit short of the plate for ball three. On deck is Jaden Birchfield. Hawks trying to jump out to an early lead. No score here in the bottom of the first. Dugout making some noise here behind Preston. The pitch. Last ball is high, ball four, walking. So Preston works out his 16th walk of the year. He'll go down and see his first base coach, Jerry Agger. Over in the third base box, as usual, is Ralph Lubegan. Hawks head JV coach, Dexter Butler, assistant coach at the varsity level on the bench there with the guys, and the skipper, Ralph Enriquez, in his normal spot just to the outside the dugout, standing in that position near the on-deck circle. Ralphie watches the ball game here at the Rex as that pitch misses, ball one to Jaden Birchfield. Jaden had a hit in yesterday's game. He was 1-for-3. Of course, not a lot of at-bats yet for Jaden, batting a 214 on the year. Does have 4 RBIs. Take that pitch in there for a strike. And he comes up here with runners at first and second. It would be nice, Judd, to get out to a lead.
Yeah, well, it'd be great.
Even yesterday, we had to come from behind in yesterday's game. Good crowd on hand here at the Rex tonight. 1-1 swung on and fouled out of play, and that'll get back to the stadium trailer park. And the count will move to 1-2. And you couldn't have a more perfect night.
Oh, beautiful night.
Nice little breeze.
Yeah, coming out of the north right now at about 5, maybe 6 miles an hour. Just beautiful night for baseball.
Nero will check the runner at second, working out of the stretch. There they go. The ball is swung on, and it's rocketed, but right at the shortstop, Rennie Ramirez, who makes the grab on the fly, and that'll do it for Key West. Birchfield put a charge into it, but right at the shortstop. For Key West, no runs on one hit. There were no errors, and two men were left out on the base paths. We got an inning in the books here. It's Key West and Westminster Christian on this Saturday night. We'll head to the second. No score. Back in 90 seconds on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WABK. to the top of the second. Great to have you aboard. Rick and Judd with you here on this Saturday night. Todd Swofford producing the ball game. And wherever you are listening along the way, glad to have you aboard. No score here as we move to the top of the second. Due to that, for the Warriors will be their 4, 5, and 6 guys. Jameer Benitez, their designated hitter, takes the first pitch from Michael Alfonso for strike one. He'll be followed by D'Angelo Ortiz and then Alan George. Alfonso made quick work of the Warriors in that top of the first inning, striking out two, face the minimum, just 3, and gets that breaking ball in there for strike two. And Judd, he's really got that breaking ball moving right now.
He's got all his pitches. He's in command of his fastball, which makes that breaking ball look that much better.
Yeah, and the skipper gave Michael the day off yesterday. He did not play in the field at the Gulliver game, getting him ready here tonight. The 0-2.
See ya, baby.
Wow, that's 3 strikeouts now out of 4 batters that he faces. And Ranier Benitez, the victim of a K. He's having a good year batting
first
345, but he strikes out
D'Angelo
here.
Ortiz.
Here comes D'Angelo Ortiz, their first baseman. If that name Ortiz sounds familiar, it should. That's Big Poppy's son, Boston Red Sox fame, at the plate. So little Poppy there right now, and he looks at this one low. Ball one. Remember, we saw him a couple of years ago when he started his high school career at Gulliver. He transferred over to Westminster Christian. So David Ortiz, Big Poppy's son, is at the plate. We'll take that one in there for strike one. He's batting 277 on the year with 10 RBIs, and he's got 1 home run. Here's the 1-1 from Alfonso, and he'll deliver this one low, ball 2. He made such quick work of the Warriors in the first. Never got a chance to tell you who's behind Michael. Conk defense tonight, Varela behind the plate. Trevor Zelch at first, Wyatt Kuhn at second. Preston Hurst over at third, Kai Smith the shortstop. Left field, Landon Lowe. Center field, Logan Pelletier. And Jaden Birchfield is in right. The 2-1, swung on it, well stroked, and that's going to find the gap out there in right center field. Quickly cutting it off is Birchfield, or holding to a single. A well stroke by Ortiz, and that's the first hit for the Warriors.
Yeah, Michael just left that fastball up a little bit, no, right over the plate, and he stroked it right out there to right center field.
Center fielder Alan George comes up. It's time for tonight's fashion report, brought to you by Ramona's Conk Creations, celebrating 50 years of taking care of all of us Conks. Ramona's is in Searstown. We'll let you know what the teams are wearing as George comes up to the plate. He's batting 327 on the season. 17 RBIs and 2 dingers. We'll look at this one low. Ball 1. Conks are in their home whites. It's the button-up shirt look here. Not the pinstripe uniform, just the plain white shirt and the plain white pants. On the left side of, on the right side of the shirt, they got a connecting KW in red. It's on the front, and also on the front, small red numbers on the left side. This pitch is in there for strike one. Big red numbers on the back, red leggings, and they're wearing the all red cap with the connecting KW in white. That's the Conks fashion report tonight. The Warriors coming up in a moment, and here we go. Here's Judd Wise.
Yeah, they've got the black leggings with the turquoise stripes outlined in pink. Solid black uniforms with a dry-fit jersey that's got Warriors in turquoise numbers on the back and their name as well. Right, all in the turquoise outlined in pink. Their hat is a solid black with a scripted, looks like Washington Nationals W in the
it's
turquoise.
It's not quite the curly W of the Nationals, but it's a W. Yeah. I'm going to have to take a point off on that one, Judd. Big swing and miss, a strike two. They've all got their pants pulled up, and they're showing the pink stripes on the leggings. And it's kind of like the Miami
Marlins.
The Miami
Heat.
I think it says like Los Warriors on it, or? This pitch is just a little bit low, ball 3. What a sharp-looking uniform for the kids, and there's tonight's fashion report brought to you by Ramona's Conk Creations in Searstown. They're open Monday through Friday from 11 to 5:30 p.m. Only place in town you can go in and get a T-shirt made right on the spot. Of course, they've got the historic and famous Conk red baseball caps with that famous connecting KW in white. You'll always find that at Ramona's in Searstown. Another toss over to the first base bag, and the runner's back in safe. So keeping a bit of an eye on Ortiz over there at first base, as the count is full here to Alan George, their center fielder. And again, what we've seen in the last couple of weeks here in Key West is we're in that twilight sky time right now. Will that have an effect on the outfield?
Yeah, not so much right now. Let's give it about another 10 minutes,
right,
Rick,
and
where
it's pretty,
we may see an effect.
It's a pretty clear sky tonight, Joe. There's no clouds
right
out there.
Very clear sky, which is nice.
So maybe it won't affect the outfielders here as we hit go into that twilight.
Oh, quick toss over the bag. Very close.
Oh, he just got back in. Michael Lashawny's got a good move, and now the skipper, Ralph Enriquez, is coming onto the field. Is he going to argue the call?
Yeah, I believe so.
He wants to go talk with the infield umpire, and Ralphie walks in front of the mound right now. And the infield umpire put his mask on, and the skipper will converse, saying, hey, I think you missed it. And the umpire just said, Ralph, no, I don't think so. And Ralph said, okay, I'll go back to the dugout. And he has a quick word for Alfonso as he heads back.
And you got to be careful because they could
make
you count.
Well, he
that,
walked
yeah
onto the mound.
Right.
So
they could count that, you know, if
as
they
a
wanted
mound
to.
Visit,
right.
But count remains full here to Alan George.
Ooh, oh, he got around
this.
Tried to check his swing. Spun out of the batter's box there. And he'll strike him out. That's already the fourth strikeout, really, in the second inning for Michael Alfonso. We gave you that strikeout total for Alfonso. 58 coming into the game to just 8 walks. As Judd mentioned, he's got all the pitches working here in the early going. And another K, 2 away. There's that big breaking ball, but this one misses to Christian Bosque for ball one. Bosque batting in the 7 hole. He's hitting right at an even clip of 300 as his pitches. So again, ball two. He's got 5 RBIs on the year, no dingers. They'll take a long look at his third base coach. And he'll dig in there. He's a right-hander. Batting from the right-hand side. I'll get it out eventually. Pitches in there for strike one. It was interesting, Judd, what Ralph wanted to do this week. We'll get into it here in just a second. 2 balls and 1 strike. As this one was swung on, popped up, and that's going to get out of play. And behind us for strike 2. Ralph wanted this to be, and I think it's something he's going to do in the future, Judd, is a rivalry week. Where what he had hoped to have happen this week was to have to play Pace on Tuesday, Gulliver on Friday, and Westminster Christian on Saturday. Ball was swung on, out of play. Couldn't quite get the Pace thing going because of some different things with COVID, but that's something to look forward to in the years to come for the skipper, Ralph Enriquez, bringing back classic matchups for Key West High School.
I like the idea.
I love it. I think we should play Pace every year. Love to play Westminster every year.
See ya.
Big breaking ball in there. He'll strike him out looking. Strikes out the side. Put it on the board here. 5 strikeouts already in this ball game for Michael Alfonso. And that'll do it for the Warriors here in the top of the second. No runs on a hit. There were no errors. And one man left on base. We played an inning and a half. No score between Key West and Westminster Christian. We're back in 90 seconds right here on your home of the Conks, the Zone, 97.7 WPG.
We played 1.5. No score.
Real money when I stun it might go overhead. I probably buy a dealership before I ever blow the bread. All my diamonds gold in the face inside my Rolly red. I eat a holy spread and I only fly in Boeing jets. All of the family got paper. We friend led to the Raiders. Pick up the phone for a check. We never check for the haters. That's what suckers do. And we say sucker proof. I got my stunning shades and I'm stunning on you. Right out.
hole when I buy it out. She wanna fuck me, tell me fly her out. Put a chandelier on her, got her shining like a lighthouse. Big fish dropping out the right place. Rabbits in the room, I got carrots on the right. Haters online, they just bad, they can't take this. Leading off with the Cubs in the bottom half of the second inning. First baseman, number 24, Trevor Zelch. First base. Everything really all over this house.
All right, here we go. Bottom of the second. Key West and Westminster Christian scoreless here. Trevor Zelch is at the plate. He's seen one pitch from Joel Pinheiro and now two, and they've both been in there. Four strikes. So Zelch in the hole, no balls and two strikes as we start this bottom of the second. Wyatt Kuhn and Nate Barroso also due to bat on 6, 7, and 8 guys here in our half of the second. The 0-2 swung on and hit hard, but right down at the second baseman. Gobbled up over there by Christian Bosque. He'll fire over to first and retire Zelch, and there's one away. 20 pitches in that first inning for Pinheiro.
Hawks
got a couple of guys on board. A single from Landon Lowe and a walk to Preston Hurst, but left him stranded out on the base paths. Here's Wyatt Kuhn. Yesterday was 0-2. Did lay down a really nice sacrifice bunt. Of course, he was part of that huge play in the seventh inning in the bottom of the seventh as he looks at this one, low ball one. They had a runner at first. They had just cut, Gulliver had just cut the lead to 5-3 on a solo home run. And Preston made that great backhanded stab on that rocket down the third base line. But Kuhn made a tremendous play on the throw that was short hopped over to second because that's all that Preston could do. And he scooped it up for that huge second out of that inning. This ball is swung on and found back into the netting for strike two. On the year, Wyatt is batting 208 with two ribbies. Getting a chance to be the Conks second baseman here. He's done a good job over there at second. Right now he's in the hole, one ball and two strikes. The 1-2. Swung on, did he? Yep. Then he struck him out. And then it was a high fastball. I thought maybe he had got a foul on it, but he never touched it. And it goes back to the backstop, and then Melendez scrambling back to the backstop. Their catcher picked it up and it uncorked one into right field. So Conks are going to get an extra out here.
Now
as Kuhn will go
Conks
in the scorecard as a strikeout, but he gets
six.
First base and the tough
Ethan
error on the catcher. So see if the Conks can take advantage of the extra out here. Here's Nate Barroso. And Nate will check his swing on the high pitch, ball one. Nate was the DH in yesterday's ball game as well. He was 0-2, but did work out a big walk there in the third inning of yesterday's game. And he scored the first run in that critical third inning where the Conks scored four runs, which would prove to be enough. The pitch is low, ball two. Two balls. To Nate. Barroso batting 265 on the year with six ribbies. In there for a strike. So just an absolute huge win for the club yesterday to prove the Conks record to 6-15 and most importantly getting rid of that 7-game losing streak, which is in there for a strike two. So, and this is an interesting note, Judd, that Conks with that win yesterday improved to 5-8 on the road, and now we've played a lot of road games, but we're just 1-7 here at home.
Yeah, time to change it around.
Yeah, and this time Barroso is going to strike out looking as Pinheiro gets that one on the outside portion of the plate to the righty.
Now betting.
And he'll strike him out.
Number three.
Third strikeout for Pinheiro. Now two away.
Shortstop.
So here's Kai Smith. Really has done a nice job and really settled in, and they've taken pressure off him by moving him down to the nine hole. And he's done a great job batting in this spot. He's on board a couple of times yesterday with a single and a walk. Scored a couple of runs. There goes the runner, the throw down to second. Not going to be in time.
That's the second time he's thrown the ball out to center field.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, he's got a strong arm, but it obviously it's not a very accurate arm right now.
A pitch missed for a ball to Smith. And a second stolen base, and that moves Kuhn into scoring position here. And the count, one ball and no strikes here to Kai. Kai now batting 259 on the year with eight ribbies. He's also worked out 14 walks. He's been fabulous at shortstop for the Cardinals. He takes a hack at this one and hits it hard, but right at the second baseman. Scooping it up is Bosque. He'll fire over to first, and the inning will come to a close. Well, the Conks got an extra out to work with here in the bottom of the second, but couldn't do anything with it. For Key West, no runs on no hits. There was one error. It didn't hurt Westminster. And Key West will leave one man out on the base pass. Well, we've completed two. Still no score between Key West and Westminster Christian. We're back in 90 seconds. You're on your home of the Conks, The Zone. That's us, WABK 97.7. Jeans that fit just right, and the radio. Well, I was raised up amid the shade of the Georgia pine, and that's homemade sweet tea, pecan pie, homemade wine, where the peaches grow. On to the third we go. Conk Baseball on the Zone is powered by Florida Keys Electric. Serving our hometown Florida Keys since 1988, specializing in residential, commercial, and government projects. No job is too big or small for Florida Keys Electric, your hometown electric. Florida Keys Electric. Call Raymond and his great crew will take it. On to the third we go, no score. Luis Mejia at the plate, and he's the right fielder. He looks at the first pitch from Michael Alfonso. It's in there for strike one. The 0-1 is low and outside, ball one. So it's the 8-9 guys, Luis Mejia and then Christian Mejia. They are twin brothers. One's the right fielder, one's the left fielder. Luis is the right fielder at the plate. He takes a hack at this one and fouls it out of play. Strike two. Also due to bat here in the third for the Warriors is their big third baseman, Sal Stewart. Alfonso's been terrific here in his first two innings. On just 28 pitches, giving up one hit, no runs. Pitch is low, ball two. He's already got five strikeouts. Two Ks in the first and struck out the side in the second. Two balls and two strikes. Swing and a miss, but it gets away from Varela. He can't pick it up as it rolled up the third base line. And Varela says, that's on me. That'll go again in the books as a strikeout. But like we had the opportunity in the bottom of the second, now Westminster Christian is going to get an extra out here.
Yep, the KE2. Yeah. That's the worst error you hate to give.
Yeah. Varela looked at Alfonso and patted his chest with his glove saying, that's on me there. But that's the sixth strikeout in the game for Alfonso. So they get the leadoff man aboard. Here's Christian Mejia, the left fielder. Also the back in, runner back in safely here. Christian batting 281 on the year with four RBIs. His brother is now down at first base batting 316. Lay this one down first baseline, and that's a great great role for him, and somehow, I don't know how, as that ball stayed fair, Alfonso's able to get on it and throw to the side of Mejia running up the line, and a big stretch, and another one of those, you know, Cirque du Soleil moves over there by Trevor Zelch, makes the grab and keeps a tippy toe on the bag, and they'll call him out.
Yep.
Gosh, that was really close. And that, I don't know, did that hit something going up the line?
No, no, it's just a great bunt that went up that line. You know, when you have this turf field, you're going to get a true roll, that's for sure.
Well, it'll go in the books as an outstanding sacrifice bunt by Christian Mejia. What the Warriors are saying, hey, he didn't have his foot on the bag, but they're going to lose that argument. They will move the other Mejia, Lewis, into scoring position with that sack bunt. And he's down at second base bag. And it's back to the top of the order. Here's Sal Stewart, the Vanderbilt committee. And the Conks aren't going to have any part of this guy. Yeah. Well, we gave you his stats here at the start of the game, batting a 548. With 25 RBIs, 11 home runs. He's running up lines. Why are you doing that to me? Because you don't let your best hitter beat you here. And now you can set up a natural double play with Jaden Melendez. He's a good one, too. He's going to FIU. They're loaded. Another good Westminster team. Evident by their 16-5 record. Check his swing, kind of half-hearted cut going around there. Strike one to Melendez. He was the victim of the strikeout back in the first inning. No balls and one strike. Second game this week for Westminster Christian. They played yesterday, well, actually their third game this week. The 0-1. Ball one. Yesterday they hosted Coral Shores and they just made quick work and beat up Hurricanes yesterday, 12-0. They no-hit the Canes. 10-run rule them in 4.5 innings. They made quick work of Coral Shores yesterday. The 1-1, big breaking ball, swing and a miss. Strike two. But they did lose on Tuesday, and a team that can really hit, boy, they got handcuffed against Miami Christian. They got shut out on Tuesday, 5-0. To Miami Christian. One ball, two strikes. A busy week, four games this week.
See ya. Oh, my goodness.
Well, it did look good.
I'm sorry.
A little early on that scene. Yeah. That boy, that you're jumping out of your seat there.
Yeah, because I thought it painted the outside corner. But I was wrong.
Didn't get the call, and the count now at two balls and two strikes. That's the big breaking ball. He went around that time, right?
Yes,
and Melendez just standing in the box, looking at the home plate umpire. Said, "No, I checked my swing," and he said, "No, you didn't," and it'll strike him out. And 7 Ks already for Alfonso. So two away now for Rene Ramirez. Two out to left field.
Number one, Rene Ramirez.
So Ramirez will dig in there. Bats from the left-hand side. Alfonso one out away from getting out of this. The Warriors have runners at first and second. Luis Mejia over at second. Sal Stewart at first. Ramirez awaits the pitch, and it's a little bit low. Ball one. Westminster Christian is at the 3A level. We are at the 4A. They're a 3A level at District 15. They share their district with Florida Christian, Gulliver, LaSalle, Ransom Everglades, and Slam Academy. The 1-0. Slam it, strike one. They're 2-0 in their district. And interesting to note, this is their third game against the Conks district, District 16 4A, where so far they're perfect. They've won both games against other teams in our district. This pitch is low, ball two. They beat Miami Springs earlier this year, 13-6. And they also beat St. Brendan's 5-1. The 2-1 on its way. Yeah, man, has he got that thing breaking. Wow. What a pretty pitch. Strike two. two balls and two strikes here. Two away, two on. Swung on and hit hard through the hole between first and second. Birchfield is up with it. They will wave Mejia home. He'll come in and score on the throw home. Let the runners move up. And it's an RBI single for Rene Ramirez, and they lead 1-0. Found that hole, Judd, between first and second.
And he advances to second on the overthrow from right field.
So, Mejia comes home to score and give Ramirez an RBI, and they lead 1-0. So, by getting that extra out, Judd.
They took advantage.
Yeah, remember, Mejia had struck out, but we couldn't complete the strikeout. And he comes home to score the first run of the ball. They lead 1-0 here, and they got runners at second and third. And that'll bring up Rainier Benitez. He struck out.
Now batting the designated hitter number 23,
in the second
Rainier
inning.
Benitez.
You know, it's funny when you see those first three guys come out, they're big boys. Then you see the cleanup hitter, and you're like, wait a minute. Something's not right in this situation.
Not quite as tall.
No.
He's got some pop in that bat, and he looks at this one for a low ball one. Westminster is led by Emil Castellanos, now his 18th year Westminster Christian's head coach. Led the Warriors to 3 state championships in his time here. Came after your old buddy Rich Hoffman.
Been there since Rich left, huh?
I think so.
Wow.
The one up, swung on, fouled out of play, over our heads, and it came down at one ball and one strike. Hawks just need one more out here. We're in the third. Got a run in on a hit. That's a nice look. Oh, said it was outside. I was ready to do what you did earlier.
Yeah.
I thought he painted that outside portion of the plate, but don't get the ball to Benitez. So the count at 2-1. Two balls, one strike to their DH. That's in the cleanup spot. Waits the pitch. There's that nice off-speed breaking ball in there, strike two. Now you're one pitch away from getting out of this. Keeping the damage minimal. Ortiz is on deck. Just got a piece of it. Morella just couldn't quite get a glove on it to hang on to it as he fouls it away for to stay alive.
A quick shout out to Coach Russ Milliken. I know he's listening and watching back there, or up there in Palm Beach. He enters his final week of the season this year, next week.
Pitch stays inside to the righty. Ball three. Yeah, everybody heading down to that final week, Judd.
Final week of the regular season.
Yep, coming up next week. Hawks will have 2 games next week. They're both here at home against Keysgate next Friday. That game will be at 7:30, and we might as well start letting you know now, the Saturday game with Keysgate, that time has changed. It's gonna be a 2:00 in the afternoon game.
Yep.
Bring your sunscreen. The 3-2. That stays high, ball four. And the bases are loaded, they're walking. So it goes in the books as the second walk this inning. Alfonso, remember, he intentionally walked Sal Stewart, who is down at third base right now. Rene Ramirez
first
at second.
12,
and Rainier Benitez, who just worked out that walk, is over at first. And that'll bring up D'Angelo Ortiz. Little poppy will dig in there. Had a nice hit in his first at bat. Took it right out.
Yes, sir.
Hitting. Took it out into right field. He's 1-for-1. And did he check his swing? Did he
no,
get a strike?
Right.
He called it a ball, right?
He did.
Yeah.
Holy cow.
Looked pretty good to me, too.
Yeah, looks real good to me.
One ball and no strikes here. Alfonso comes home. That one stays inside, but he gets the call this time as Ortiz was backing off the plate. Alfonso gets the strike call. One ball and one strike. Swing just a little bit low. Two balls and one strike.
Two
Ortiz with a long look down at third base. Now will get himself set. Base is loaded. Alfonso will work out of the stretch and comes home with the pitch. Well, swung on, popped up the first base line. Zelch giving it a look in foul territory. The only guy who had a play on it was actually Joey Cook.
Yeah.
Standing in the
I don't even know if he saw it coming.
His visitor's bullpen down there.
Bring him to the 11th Half Comp Cafe for a free soda.
So that's strike two as that one just gets out of play. So again, you're one pitch away from getting out of this big mess. Now.
Do we see that big breaking ball coming right here?
I would love it right now. 2-2 count. Let's see what Michael does. Saw him, there it is. But he won't take a hack at it. But it's off the plate now. He can't walk him.
Everybody's moving on the windup right here. There you go.
Two outs, bases loaded. The count is 3-2 to Ortiz. The Warriors have got one in, threatening big time here, but Mike just needs one pitch to get out of this. There's that 3-2. That's a big strikeout as he strikes out D'Angelo Ortiz. So he ends up striking out the side. Now 8 Ks, but in between those strikeouts, the Warriors were able to pick up a run on a hit, helped out by a Key West error, and they left 3 on the base pass. So the damage was minimal to Key West here in the top of the third. We'll head to the bottom of the third. It's now Westminster Christian 1, Key West nothing, back in 90 seconds here. When you're home with the Conks in the Zone, 97.7.
Key West High School would like to acknowledge and thank tonight's baseball sponsors. They include Gary the Carpenter, the Comp House, Ron Russo, Zelch and Zelch Accounting, the Hurricane Hole, Matheson, Spartan Construction of the Keys, and MJW Parts. Thank you to our baseball sponsors. And again, help Key West High School with those foul balls. Bring it back to the 11th Time Comp Cafe for free soda. She know that the youngest son was always guaranteed to get the money. Okay, let's go. She know that the baby boy was always guaranteed to get the loot. She know what I do. She know if I run from it, I'm gonna pull it out. Shoot. PTSD. I'm always waking up a cold sweat. Like I got the food. Boy, her teeth. She started killing me. Front of me. Boy, here's a tooth. I'm gonna kill a man with a tooth. My little man, you send me here. As long as you know that I'm about to tell you if you don't believe. Let's go. Brand new Lamborghini. For the Conks in the bottom half of the third inning, center fielder number 1, Spike Palacier, center field.
On to the bottom of the third we go. It's Conk Baseball here on the Zone, 97.7 WAVK on the World Wide Web at thezone977.com. Swinging at the first pitch is Logan Palacier. We're back to the top of the order. He fouls it away. Offering from Joel Pinheiro for strike one. Westminster Christian picking up a run in the top of the third inning, and they lead 1-0. Palacier 0-1 today as he flew out to right field. And his one at bat back in the first inning. Pinheiro comes home, and another hack by Spike, and he fouls it back into the netting for strike two. So Palacier, Landon Lowe, Daniel Barella, top of the order for Key West here as we get the third underway.
Another shout out, George Riseco. Thank you for helping out Rick yesterday. George, I really appreciate that.
It was good to see George there. We had a good crowd. Monkholz at Gulliver yesterday. This pitch is outside, ball one. George is our Miami coordinator for the Zone. It's always good to see George. He did want to make sure that you gave me my share of the honey buns.
You got them all right.
I did. I told him. You did give them to me. Ball is dropped on and looped and blooped out into right field, just beyond the reach of the second baseman, Christian Bosque, and it drops from the right fielder, Luis Mejia, and there's a leadoff single for Spike.
Now batting for the Conks.
So we need speed on the base.
You talk about that speed of Spike Pelosier. Judd, he made one heck of a play yesterday at Gulliver, deep in the gap in right center field, chase one down. Part of that outstanding defensive effort in that game yesterday. Quick toss over the bag on the back end.
Yeah, remember, and the catch he made the week before was outstanding in the gap over here in left center field.
So great speed over at first base for Key West. He was landing low. He's one for one today. He'll take a hack at this one. Behind the catcher for strike one. Ended up with an infield single on a ball that he got just past the third baseman back in the first inning, knocked down by the shortstop, holding to a single. It's a hit for Orlando. Swung on and ripped just to our left, and he's in the hole. No balls and two strikes. Historically, between these two teams, Key West has won two of the last three meetings. And the last time we played each other, time was called before the pitch was thrown. Judd, you'll remember this, when we met in that very memorable game in 2019 at Light Stadium at UM.
Beautiful park.
Yeah, we had a fun night that night. No balls, two strikes here to Lowe. There's a fastball, just misses. That's in there. Ball one. And you go back to that game in 2019. Hawks ended up losing 9-8. But Key West rallied with six runs in the final three innings to tie up the game and send it to the bottom of the seventh. Big swing and a miss. He gets the chase one low and outside. A strike out for Pinheiro. That's strikeout number four. There's Daniel Varela. He was a victim of a strikeout in his one at bat back in the first inning.
Now batting, the catcher.
Thinking of that home run that Daniel hit yesterday, when you go back to that last game that we played at Mark Light Stadium against the Warriors, two big home runs for the Hawks that night. Quick toss over the bag. Mason Miller had a pinch hit two-run homer in the sixth inning of that game. And then Dane Black hit a three-run home run in the top of the seventh to tie it up. This ball is swung on and lifted way foul down the left field line out toward Point Siena School for strike one. But Westminster Christian was able to get the game-winning run across the plate at the bottom of the seventh. Of course, one of the most memorable games ever between the two schools happened way back in 1996. Toss over to the bag. And again, that game was played at Mark Light Stadium on the campus of the University of Miami. You go back to 96, Key West won a state championship that year, as well as Westminster Christian won a title that year. But it had big time national attention. And I'll tell you why in just a second. The 0-1, they'll wait as they throw the first. Going into that game at Mark Light, Key West was ranked number one in the country. Westminster Christian was ranked number two in the nation. The 0-1. Bit high, ball one. It was a crazy game that went down to the end. Westminster Christian won that game 3-2. That year, they would go on to be named the USA Today National champions of high school baseball. Big swing and miss, strike one. But it's also interesting to note in that year of 1996 and that very memorable game, both teams would end up winning state championships.
Right.
Yeah.
And they won almost, I think, 70 games between them almost.
But 1-2, there goes the runner, swing and a miss, he'll strike him out. The throw down to second is in time.
Strike him out.
Yep. And the Hawks get cut down here in the bottom of the third. That time, Jaden Melendez threw a beanie down there to second base, and the tag was made. And that'll do it for Key West. So for the Hawks, no runs on a hit. There were no errors, and nobody left. We played three. It's still Westminster Christian 1, Key West nothing. We're back in 90 seconds. But you're home with the Hawks, the zone, 97.7 WADK. Thank you.
si tú me tiras, vamos a nadar en lo hondo. Si por mí te lo pongo, de septiembre hasta agosto. Como sin cojones, lo que digan tu amiga, ya yo me enteré. Se nota cuando.
On to the fourth we go. So nice to have you with us. Just a perfect night for baseball. Where would you rather be than right here, right now at Rex Weech Field? If you can't make it, you're tuned in to us. We're so glad to have you along for the ride here. Good ball game here as we move to the top of the fourth. Westminster Christian with the 1-0 lead. Michael Alfonso getting his remaining warm-up tosses here before we begin the fourth inning. Juddy ended up throwing a lot of pitches in that third inning of 30.
Right, we need a quick 1-2-3 right here, Michael, so we can cut that pitch count down.
Throwing only 28 through the first two, but had to labor a bit there in the third. It was a big-time threat from the Warriors. They had the bases loaded, but they only were able to get one run in. So tight ball game here as we move to the fourth. By the way, Michael has struck out 8 already in this ball game through 3 innings.
All right, quick shout out to Monica Fletcher, Gina Smith listening. All right, and you know, they always make me laugh at school, and I just want to make sure they got their shout out.
Here's Alan George. Hi, girls. Good to have you along with us. As that pitch is a little high to George. Ball one, George, a victim of a strikeout back in the second inning. Gets spun off the plate here. Ball two. So whenever these two teams get together, Judd, you can't help but talk about state championships because these two schools are now tied, having the most titles in the state of Florida. Pitches in there for strike one. For the Warriors, their run began in the 80s. The Key West run began way back in the 1950s. The 2-1 swung on and fouled back to the backstop. So here's a list. Here's the list of the state championships, of the years that Westminster has won them. 81, 88, 1990, 92. A-Rod was on that team. 94.
Yes, sir.
Pitcher's in there. Strike three. He'll strike him out looking. George just puts his head down. Ninth strikeout of the game for Alfonso. Wow. Here's Christian Bosque. He'll come up to the plate.
Second baseman, number 30, Christian.
Okay, they also won state titles in 96, 97, 98, 2009, 2010. This ball is swung on by Bosque and fouled out of play for strike one. And their last title came 6 years ago in 2015. In 1992 and in 96. Pitch is low, ball one. They were USA Today's national champions. One ball, one strike. Swung on, chopped down to third. Tough hop there for Preston, but he stays with it. He pulls Trevor off of the bag, but trying to slide underneath the tag was Bosque, but the infield umpire is right there up the first base line. He says, no, he tagged him. That ball took a funny hop there, kind of short hop Preston. So he had to get the quick throw, and it brought Trevor up the line, and he was waiting to tag him. Good try there by Bosque
to
slide underneath
exactly.
It. But he's
very close, but he got tagged.
5-3 on the put out there, and that brings up Luis Mejia.
This is what we need, Michael. We need a 1-2-3, baby.
Yeah.
Keep that pitch down, count down.
First pitch to Mejia, missed for a ball. The next one
should be it.
Just popped up into right field. Who's going to get it? J. Jaden Birchfield is there, but he'll give way to the second baseman, Wyatt Kuhn. It took a long time to come down, but Kuhn makes the grab, and the inning comes to a close. Just what the doctor ordered, a 1-3 inning for Michael Alfonso. For the Warriors, no runs on no hits. There were runs, and nobody left on base. We played 3.5. It's Westminster Christian 1, Key West nothing. We're back in 90 seconds here. On your home of the Cons, that's us, the Zone, 97.7 WAVK.
In the bottom half of the fourth inning, third baseman number 10, Preston Hurst.
All right, here come your Cons as we head to the bottom of the fourth inning. Westminster Christian leading 1-0. Preston Hurst will lead things off against Joel Pinheiro. A swing at the first pitch and chop it in the hole at short. Backhanded stab by Ramirez.
No
way. Long throw, not going to beat it.
Not even close.
Preston Hurst digs out an infield single.
Yep.
And the Warriors bench jumps out, say, hey, they got him, but Preston with that good speed. That was a tough play for Reddy Ramirez.
No question.
Deep in the hole, backhanded stab, has to plant the foot and then make the long throw. Her speed beats it out.
Number 22, Jake Birch.
So here for the Cons in our half of the fourth, the 4, 5, and 6 guys. Hurst getting on board with the hit there. He's followed by Jaden Birchfield and also Trevor Zelch due to bat here. Jaden hit the ball hard and is one at bat back in the first inning, lined out to the shortstop, going to try and lay down the bunt, but bunts it off the plate and foul for strike one. So Judd, I just gave you all the years that Westminster Christian won state titles. They've got 11. I'm going to test your Key West knowledge here. Key West also with 11. Can you tell me the years that Key West has won our state championship?
I'm going to go with 53, 54, 55, 58, 59.
No.
They won 5 in the 50s. I know that.
They did win 5 in the 50s.
Then 69, 84, 95, 96, 98.
Those were all right. Yeah.
05, last one.
So you're a little confused on the 50s.
Okay. I was close, though.
You were close. I'll give it to you. You just reeled off the 50s too quick. You needed to think about it for a second.
I thought that's what I was trying to think in my memory.
Right.
I mean, I could have cheated and looked at my pen.
Don't. Okay. No, I ask you not to do
that.
I know that. Okay?
I didn't. I gave you everything.
Oh! Man, he's showing bunt, and that pitch comes inside, and that's off his chest. I mean, literally right where his heart is. And, Jaden, do not talk to the other coach. Just walk down to the base pad. Now, they're arguing that he put the bat out there to try to bunt it. The pitch runs inside, and I mean literally right off the heart on his chest there as he got plunked. And he'll go down to the first base bag.
Yep.
So an argument ensuing with the home plate umpire. And now, and their head coach, Neil Castellanos, said he wants the infield umpire to overrule him. And he's getting his 2 cents in worth right now, and not going to change the call. As Jaden gets hit with that pitch as it runs inside. He was showing bunt. He was diving away. Bailed in and got him.
Number 24.
First batter hit by Pinheiro. So, Hawks got something cooking here. See if they can take advantage. Nobody down. Runners at first and second. Jayden is okay. Here's Trevor Zelch. He's 0-for-1 today. Pinheiro steps off of the rubber and fake throw over to second base. I'll give you those years here in just a second, because the 1950s were the golden age for Conk baseball, where they did win 5 state championships. Gonna put the bunt down again. It's punted hard at the third baseman. He comes up with it at Sal Stewart. They'll fire across the diamond to first and get the out there, but well-executed sacrifice bunt off the bat of Trevor Zelch, and that's something Ralphie was talking about in the pregame show, as they're getting better on the bunts. We're better yesterday in the game at Gulliver, and right there, Judd, Trevor does a really good sack bunt up the third base line.
Yeah, scored 5-4 as the first baseman came charging in. Runners at second and third now with one out.
Yeah, so both runners in scoring position for Wyatt Kuhn. Kuhn awaits the pitch, and it's in there for a strike. Kuhn got aboard back in the second inning. He actually struck out, but the catcher missed the ball, and he got down to first base. And then in the top of the third inning, that happened to Westminster Christian. They had a batter strikeout. He got down to first base. We couldn't complete the strikeout. But the difference there was that guy came around to score. And that's the difference in the ballgame right now. 1-0 game. Conk's trying to change that right now. The 0-1. Just a little bit low and outside. And the count at 1-1.
And this game's got a little bit of a feel like that championship game, Rick. I'm telling you, both coaches are hot and heavy into coaching this game and letting the umpires know it and everything else.
One ball and one strike. The pitch, breaking ball outside. Ball two. All right, so here's the Conk State Championships. The first one came in 1953. Number 2 came in 55, number 3 in 56, then 58 and 59.
So I got 3 of the 5.
Yeah.
Okay. Not bad.
Yeah, but that's not 5 of the 5.
Well,
it's okay. I mean, it's good. It's
9
good.
Out of 11, okay.
58, 59, of course, Boog Powell, George Myra teams.
Yeah.
You got everything else. Oh, ball swung on, foul back to the backstop. We had one title in 1969, the team known as the Hitless Wonders. Those guys don't like that nickname, but it stuck behind Randy Sterling.
And in the 56 semifinals of the state tournament, Kiwis High pitcher Tony Hoppe struck out 18 Lakeland High batters to tie Herb's score for the most ever in a state championship semifinal.
I got to think that record probably still stands, Judd.
It probably does.
This pitch is lower ball. 18 in one game? Unless Randy Sterling broke it.
Yep.
Sterling, part of that 69 team. And of course, Hawks rode his arm to that title. Hawks had no titles in the 70s. The 3-2. Swung on and fouled.
That was ball four right there.
Back into the backstop. Yeah, he did swing a ball four. The count remains full. But this is interesting here, Judd. You know, the Key West did not win a state championship in the 70s, but we did have a title in the 70s here in Key West. Mary Immaculate.
Yes.
Their big anniversary of their 1972 team that won a state championship is next year.
Bill Zumbrace, head coach.
It's the one state championship while the Mariners played high school baseball. Came back in 1972. Of course, the Hawks would win again in 84. 95, 96, 98, three titles in a glorious decade.
And we
of the
lost 90s. In 94.
And we lost in 94, right. And then our last title came in 2005. The 3-2 swung on, hit back up the middle, and the shortstop somehow comes down with it behind the bag, but he's got no play. The Conks have tied it up on the infield single, and the RBI off the bat of Wyatt Kuhn. Hey, hey, it's a 1-1 game.
Yep, Wyatt just took that fastball, swung nice knee, made solid contact. Great play by the shortstop to get over there, all right? But not enough to make any kind of throw. He's smart enough to hold on to the ball. runners at the corners.
Yeah, you don't, you know, yeah, that was an outstanding get to that ball by Ramirez, the shortstop, and then very wisely does not try to do a 360 spin and fire to first base and create more damage. Now Ralph Enriquez is coming out of the dugout, and he's asking for the trainer to come out. I think we want to take a quick look at Wyatt Kuhn, make sure that he is okay when he was running up the line, that he didn't sprain an ankle or something. I didn't notice anything. But Kuhn comes up with a key hit here. They're gonna take him out?
Yep. At least for right now.
Let's see if they're gonna bring in a
Wyatt.
That was his third RBI of the year. He's done. He's only a sophomore, and he's getting his opportunities here late in the season. He's done a good job over at second base and comes up with a good hit here. They'll bring Jack Haggard in to run for him right now over at first base. He'll be attended to right now in the dugout. Hopefully Wyatt can get back out there. Here's Nate Barroso. He comes up with one away here. Runners on the corners. One in. We're tied at one in the bottom of the fourth.
Westminster's keeping the defense back, looking to turn a double play.
Rosso awaits that first pitch, and Pinheiro delivers the fastball in there. Strike one. Pinheiro got Barroso. Caught him looking with a strikeout back in the second. Pinheiro's got five Ks in the game. He's walked one, and he's hit a bat.
Please.
They got the squeeze on, and everybody's going to be safe. An RBI bunt squeeze single there. Coming home is Jaden Birchfield. He'll score. The only thing Pinheiro could do was scoop it with his glove and then flip it right from his glove to his catcher, and Melendez couldn't bring it in. Everybody's safe, and the Conks have the lead for the first time today, 2-1. On the RBI suicide squeeze, Bunsen.
Now that is
great call
stop.
Right there by the number coach.
Three.
Great execution by Nate Burrows.
Smith. Number three.
So way to go, Nate. Great job. Runners now at first and second, and the Conks lead 2-0. Third hit this inning. Well, you don't obviously have to hit it hard, Judd.
Nope.
Two infield singles and a bunt single.
We'll take it.
And he's brought two runs home. And the hit batter really hurt Pinheiro as Birchfield was able to come home and score right there. There's a wild pitch. Going to get past the catcher. He's going to fire down to second base. And that's a great throw. And they are going to get Barroso. Melendez starting to dial it in behind the plate, Judd. His first couple of tosses down to second base sailed on him. He's now caught a couple guys. So the wild pitch allows Kuhn, Jack Haggard running for Kuhn, get down to third base. Barroso is caught, trying to get down to second base on a great throw by the catcher. So there's two away now. As Kai Smith is at the plate. What's your count on Kai?
I had 2-1, but I think it's 3-1. We'll find out.
3-1 on the count to Kai Smith with everything going on. Kai 0-1 today. Takes a hack at this one and another level up the first baseline. Pinheiro will field it, go to first, and get the out. And the inning will come to a close. But the Conks pick up two runs on three hits. There were no errors here for the Warriors, and we will leave
for your
one man out on the base path. So for the first time in this game, Key West has the lead as we head to the fifth. It's Key West 2, Westminster Christian 1. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, the Zone, 97.7 WAVK.
Thank you.
ladies and gentlemen, it's a good time to remind you the 11 Time Cock Cafe is cooking up everything that you need to cure those top of the fifth inning munchies. They're grilling hamburgers. They've got sodas, a wide variety of food items. Please visit the 11 Time Cock Cafe. Support your fighting songs. And a special shout out and thanks to everyone at the Hurricane Bowl for sponsoring the food items all year long at the 11 Time Conk Cafe. Thank you, Hurricane Hole.
Great to have you aboard. It's Conk Baseball here on the Zone. Got a good one here on this Saturday night at the historic Rex Weech Field here in Key West. Conks now lead Westminster Christian by the score of 2-1 as we move to the top of the fifth inning. And the fifth inning of every Conk baseball game is brought to you by First State Bank of Florida Keys. We've got 11 locations Keys wide to serve you better. Last and only locally owned bank in the Keys. And you know what?
Leading off
they've
the
been
Warriors
serving all
the top of the fifth inning
since
is elected
at
number 18, Christian Mejia.
It'll be the Mejia brothers, the twin brothers, Luis Mejia and Christian Mejia. Then back to the top of the order, Sal Stewart. As Michael Alfonso works into the fifth and delivers his first pitch to, pardon me, it's Christian Mejia leading things off. His twin brother made the final out back in the fourth inning. So Christian Mejia, the number 9 hitter, leads things off. Then back to the top of the order, Sal Stewart and Jake Melendez do the bat. And he'll look at this one in there for a strike. So the count at 1-1 for Michael, 68 pitches. Through 4 innings. He had to labor through the third where they got their 1 run. But he's been on tonight, folks. 9 strikeouts, 2 walks. One of those walks was intentional. The 1-1 is high, ball 2. And he got that quick 1-2-3 inning in the fourth after he labored there in the third.
And that was a big inning, get that 1-2-3 to come back like that.
That pitch will get in there, strike 2 to Christian Mejia, who laid down a sacrifice bunt in his only at bat in the ball game, that set up, helped set up that 1 run that they scored. 2 balls, 2 strikes here. Swung on and fouled out of play. And the count remains at 2 balls and 2 strikes.
All right, got another shout out going up to Jacksonville, Florida, where my wife Penny is, taking care of her sister Patty, who's coming off some surgery. So Patty and Penny and Danny, hey, listen, thanks for listening to us up there, and get well, Patty.
If everything is okay there, the 2-2.
See ya!
Swing and a miss, and Penny Judd's in rare form tonight.
Yeah,
baby.
That is the 10th strikeout of the ball game for Michael Alfonso. 10.
Yep, his season high is 12, I believe, right?
We'd have to go back.
Third baseman number 4,
Sal
Stewart.
That was K number 10. Put that on the board for Alfonso. Back to the top of the order. Here's Sal Stewart. Big third baseman. Man's committed to Vanderbilt. Pushing 600 with his batting average. Takes that one in there for strike 1. Officially, he's 0-for-1. Michael struck him out on 3 pitches. Oh, and just got hit here. Not what he wanted to do. And Stewart is hot. He throws the bat violently down back toward the dugout. And that's the last thing you want to do is hit him in that situation. But Sal didn't like it. His first base coach will calm him down right now.
Yeah.
As he took that one up off the arm there and his left arm. And that has been an issue for Michael Judd is the hit batters.
Yeah.
As he hits another one here. First one in this game, but that's the 13th time Michael has plunked an opponent. Here's Jaden Melendez. Struck out both times that he's come up to the plate. He's free swinging and takes a big hack. He's going downtown, strike 1. If you're new to the Rex, we got a big ballpark here, this beautiful ballpark. 315 down the left field line. 306 down the right field. There goes the line. And he get hit too.
Yep.
Off-speed breaking ball off his hip. Goodness. Back-to-back hit batters. Man. After we strike out the first guy.
And Stewart was off. He was trying to steal the base.
He was heading down there for second base. But it could slow up after Melendez got plunked with that pitch. So back-to-back hit batters. Pitch runners at first and second. Hawks right now holding on to a 2-1 lead, but Warriors coming back and threatening here.
Come on, Michael. We need the pitcher's favorite play right now, the ground ball for two.
There's Rennie Ramirez, the shortstop. This one is into the carpet. Nice scoop there by Daniel Varela to keep the runners right where they're at. Ball one, traveling road secretary. Jack Kearns delivering another Pepsi game break. Pepsi, the official soft drink of your Key West Cards. The one out, swung on and hit hard, and it's cut off by Zelch. He'll go to second for one. Back to first,
the Benjamin! Holy cow! Scoring 3-6-1 on the double play. How about that? How's
oh,
it going?
Baby.
Goodness gracious.
It sound like Susan Waldman there. But what a play by Zelch. I didn't even think he could get to that ball. That thing was destined for right field, but he got a glove on it and then turns to 3-6-1 double play, and that ends the Warrior threat here in the top of the fifth. No runs on no hits. There were no errors and one man left. We played 4.5. We're in the middle of the First State Bank Florida Keys fifth inning. It's still Key West 2, Westminster Christian 1. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone. 97.7.
I'm obviously winning. Don't make me go hit the bank. Take out 100 to show you our pockets are different. I'm out with you. So now I'm the more knowledge. She got a little mileage. I'm chilling. You disrespect me and I beat you.
For the Warriors. In front of your partners, the top half of the fifth inning. No runs. No hits. No errors. One base runner.
Put that on your head and make one of your partners some
change. And a Zelch.
With me, then you gotta grow up.
To Alfonso. Double play. The end of the inning. We play 4.5. Score U.S. 2. Westminster 1.
I don't like to argue. I don't. Ain't gonna be no more laughing. You see me whip out because I'm gonna be the shot man. No cap. I don't follow no don't lie, but all your they follow him. And that little angry with that gun, he just pull it out in his pitch. Packing the mail, it's gone. She like I smell cologne. Yeah, I just on the deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah. I go how I want, good, good. Play if you want, let's go. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Packing the mail, it's gone. She like I smell cologne. Yeah, I just on the deal, I'm on. Yeah, yeah. I go how I want, good, good. Play if you want, let's go. I'm a young CEO, sure. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Talking about that, I'm a pocket. Got like 32,000 in one of my pockets. The other one, that's where the block is. Block. You little nigga wanna be in that gangster mentality. Look, stop it. I beat a Burmese in front of the store where your mammy and grandmama shop. I hopped out on a whole other wave on it. They see one, they little top it. I return and took a burden. Push me a little top it. I work with the hate. Calling the groupie just cause she like all my music. She just sent me a text and delete the message. She trying to find out it's confused.
Leading off for the Fighting Conks. The top half, bottom half of the fifth inning. Center fielder number one, Spike Pelosi.
Off to the bottom of the First State Bank of the Florida Keys fifth inning. Key West leading 2-1, and see if they can build on that huge double play that ended the top of the fifth. Back to the top of the order, it's going to be Spike Pelosier, followed by Landon Lowe and Daniel Varela. On for his fifth inning of work is the FIU signee, Joel Pinheiro, son of the big leaguer, and this one is a little bit low, ball one. Pinheiro held the Conks to two runs on five hits. Struck out five, walked one. He's thrown 64 pitches through the first four innings, and that pitch is high, ball two. Two balls and no strikes. The 2-0. Right in there, strike one. Congratulations to the Lady Conk softball team. Big win last night. Almost had a perfect game. Oh, Guidi almost had a perfect game last night for Key West. Broken up in the last inning on an infield single. The Conks knocked off Marathon and finished their regular season.
7-5 as they head to the playoffs.
Yep. And they will be, they get a week off now, and they're already in the playoffs.
Yep.
But they got something big to do coming up. Big swing and miss, strike two. They will be the number one seed in their district tournament, more than likely play St. Brendan's. And you want to win that game to make sure you're at home to start the playoffs.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Oh, Spike, he went golfing at ball four right there.
Speaking of which, I will be out on the Key West Golf Course tomorrow, Judd.
All right.
Hacking away. 3-2. This is ball four. He's walked him, so Spike on board for the second time today. Had a single back in the third inning.
Now batting for the Cox,
but he was
left
a
fielder.
Part of that strike him out, number throw him four. Out. When Varela landed. Struck out, he tried to steal second base.
Low.
And that ended the third inning. So he's back over there at first base. Officially, Spike 1-for-2 today with a walk. He just earned that walk right now. Here's Lando. He'll look at this pitch in there for strike one. Landon had an infield single back in the first inning, struck out the third, so 1-for-2. Just having a marvelous year is low. They'll take that pitch for ball one, and what happened there?
Mike stole the base.
Kind of a delayed steal there, and then Melendez wanted to throw down there, but nobody was covering the bag, so he'll get credited with a stolen base there. And the count now at 1-1 here. Third swipe tonight for Key West as Conks have been getting on board. We've been running. So he's in scoring position with nobody out. Conks trying to build on this 2-1 lead. Now Lowe's going to show bunt. And Pinheiro will step off the rubber. They're going to get out there. And then my buddy, City Commissioner Greg Davila, go play a little golf tomorrow.
Mr. Hungate playing with you?
Hungate is not playing.
Okay.
Yeah. It's the boys of 85, class of 85.
Oh, I like that.
Brett Christian and Kenny Blakeout.
All right.
Greg Davila and Rick Lopez. Yeah. Be quite the foursome. The 1-1. And Lowe tries to put the bunt down, but it's off the bat foul.
I was wondering, can any of you all shoot 85 before you get to the 18th hole?
That's possible. That's possible. Me and Davila are just getting our games going.
Oh, here we go.
Kenny's been playing for like 25 straight days.
Exactly.
Brett plays quite a bit, so let's see what we do out there. Actually, I played pretty good the last time I went out, so I'm looking forward to getting back out on the course. Jack Niles just chiming in. Calling it the Karma Chameleon crew,
there you
my
go.
Crew, which is a funny story because that's kind of an inside joke, but I don't need to go into detail. But it happened at a Christmas party. Yeah. I tried to get all my buddies to get their wives and all that to come out on the dance floor. Here's our song.
Oh, my God.
Nobody would follow me. No, not even my own wife.
I can believe
out.
That.
My own wife refused to go out on the dance floor with me.
I can believe that.
Yeah. 1-2. This high. Ball two. Two balls and two strikes.
People have seen you try to move Lopez.
Well, I mean, I told all the guys, I've got a great song for us. It's our song. Come on, guys. And I think it's a great song.
Yeah.
It's fun.
Yeah.
Hip. Catchy. Hip-hop. Yeah. You dance to it. And nobody came. Well, that's why Jack calls it the Karma Chameleon crew. Yeah. The weather's been perfect. I mean, what a gorgeous weekend.
Yes.
Had the 7-mile bridge run today.
They
did that. They did that today. That went off well. The 2-2. Breaking ball swung on and found back into the net.
Speaking of it, fact checker, if you're listening, what was your time today? We wanted, or did you even get up?
Probably passed out right now. You know, he's not here. Or
no.
If he's here, he didn't come over and say
no,
hi.
No, he's
I thought
not
we'd
here.
See him today.
Yeah.
Kevin Leslie, a good friend of station and the program, Judd and myself. Man in the race, he's from Naples. This ball is chopped down to the shortstop. Ramirez gloves it, fires over to first to get the out there. But Lowe does advance Pellicer down to third.
Yep. He had to come charge that ground ball. And when he had to charge it, that gave Spike the chance to take off and go to third base.
The catcher.
There's the Conk catcher, Daniel Varela, coming up to the plate. He's 0-for-2 today. He'll have to wait a moment as the Warriors are calling timeout. They're bringing the entire infield in. Are they going to go get Pinheiro?
No, I don't think so. I think what they're talking about is watch out for that squeeze again.
Right. And the Conk successfully running suicide squeeze in the fourth inning. working and working and working on the bunting, and it's starting to pay off for Key West.
If you're Westminster, do you pull the defense, do you pull the infield in here, Rick?
Well, there's only one down. The runner over at third in a tight ball game where you got the two number one starters. Every run is so important here.
And the way Michael is pitching right now.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can afford to give up a third run. I think you got to pull the infield in myself.
See what the Warriors do here. And look, looks like that's what they're going to do. Play the infield in to try to get the play at the plate. Barella's 0 for 2, victim of a K in both appearances, in the first and the third. He's not bunting, and he swings and lines a rocket right back to the pitcher.
Wow.
What a play.
You can't hit it any harder than that. Right on the screws.
What a play by Pinheiro. I mean, it's nothing but all reaction as that ball is ripped back up the middle. He gets the glove out there, makes the grab, and then able to turn the double play because your natural motion over at third is going to take you forward Spike couldn't get back, so score of the DP, 1-5 on the great reaction play by the Warriors pitcher, Joel Pinheiro. That'll keep the Conks off the scoreboard here in the fifth inning. For Key West, no runs on no hits. There were no errors and nobody left. That'll do it for the First State Bank of the Florida Keys fifth inning. We'll head to the sixth. It's Key West 2, Westminster Christian 1. Back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Conks, The Zone. 97.7 WABK.
Now playing left field for the Conks, 27, Landon Rady. Rady in left field. Landon Lowe moves to second base.
Fun at the old ballpark, you can't beat it. Had a couple of great games this week. Yesterday, Key West knocking off Gulliver 5-3 up in Miami. And here tonight at the Rex, the Conks have a 2-1 lead over Westminster Christian as we move to the top of the sixth inning. Rick Lopez, along with my broadcast partner, Judd Wise, Todd Swafford producing tonight's ball game. Glad to have you aboard. Due to bat for the Warriors here in their half of the sixth, the 4-5 six guys. Near Benitez, D'Angelo Ortiz, and Alan George. Conks have to make a couple of defensive changes as Wyatt Kuhn is now out of the ballgame after he had got down to first base and something happened there. So he's out of the game. Landon Lowe has come in from left field. He's now playing a second base, and Andon Rady has come off the bench, and he moves in to left field. Back out on the hill for his sixth inning of work is Michael Alfonso. And he delivers the first pitch, and it's hit right back to him as he just goes to the third base side of the mound. That was Renier Benitez swinging at the first pitch, and one pitch and one down, and a great start here in the
first
sixth.
First baseman number 12, D'Angelo
Alfonso.
Ortiz.
Yep, great job by Michael. He only threw 12 pitches in that last inning, so he's keeping that count down.
I got him at 79 coming into this inning. That was his 80th pitch of the game, and he got the out. Here's D'Angelo Ortiz. He takes that one for ball one. Ortiz 1-for-2, singled back in the second, struck out in the third. One of 10 strikeouts in this ballgame. for Alfonso. Big swing and miss for a strike. How about the freshman yesterday for the Conks, Judd? What a performance by the youngster Jacob Burnham. A complete game, seven innings.
I think
he got hit again. Yeah, as that catches a portion of his shirt on that inside fastball, and that's the third hit batter this game for Alfonso.
Right. Oh, Michael.
You don't need that. But he's firing it inside, and as Ortiz is bending out of the way, the ball catches a piece of his shirt. You can see it.
Yeah.
And he's down there at the first base back. But again, back to Burnham. Just 80 pitches in seven innings of work. That's pretty remarkable. And the kid's just getting better and better.
11 pitches an inning? Yeah. You'll take that all season long.
Here's Alan George. He'll take a hack at this one and foul on play for strike one.
Quick shout out, Carl Sombach. You're keeping this field looking great, Carl. The outfield looks super. Right, infield looks fantastic. Proud of you, Carl, the way you're doing it.
Judd, this is a new batter. It's not Alan George. It is Jake Suarez.
Suarez, all right.
Jake Suarez taking over in George's spot, the center fielder. And he's in all no balls and one strike. It's Alan George struck out two times. He had come to the plate here tonight. So they bring in a lefty, Suarez. The 0-1. Big breaking ball. Oh, come on.
Wow.
How did that miss?
I don't know.
Jeepers, creepers. Where'd you get those? Peepers.
Yeah.
All right. Let's
stop, please.
Yeah, I thought that was a strike. The 1-1. Now it's high. Ball two. 2-1. No action in the pen for Key West right now. Ralphie is really hoping that Michael can get through this sixth inning. And make a decision. The 2-1. Swung on, that one is down into left field. Here's Rady. He comes over and makes a great sliding catch. Wow! And he's going to go get a high five from Logan Pelissier. Runs all the way over there. What a catch, kid! Wow!
Great job by Rady. He got a tremendous jump on the ball. Looked like it was going to be going towards the line. Plus, it's tailing away from him. Diving outreach with the hand and comes up with a huge catch.
What do you think, a nominee?
That.
Garrison Plate Marina catch of the day?
It could be.
Swinging at the first offering is Christian Bosque. And he lifts it foul and out of play for strike one. Bosque 0-2 today. But there, Rady coming off the bench and getting into left field. The kid's got great speed. And he's able to get to that one as he had to sprint toward the line and dives for it and comes up with just an absolute huge play. And if it gets by him,
that's going to score a run.
That would have definitely scored a run. So just a tremendous play by Rady.
But instead, we got two outs.
Two down. Quick toss over to the bat.
You know, we got a pinch runner in for Ortiz, too, number 16.
Okay. And that is Sebastian Gonzalez. Running over at first. The 0-1, swing and a miss on the high fastball, strike two.
You know, I got to believe that was supposed to be a hit and run, and Gonzalez didn't go. But we'll take it. That's two strikes now.
Radar gun had that one at 84, but I think it's about 3 miles under. So
I don't know.
Probably about 87, close to 90 on that fastball. The 0-2. Big looping breaking ball as he came back after the big fastball with the slow breaking ball. He doesn't get the call, ball one. It's funny, looking across over at the Conk dugout, you see all the kids hopping up and down and doing 360s. They thought that was
well, they understand the importance of this game.
Oh, it's huge. Ball is swung on and fouled out of play. In the overall scheme of things, a win or a loss doesn't affect what's going to happen in the district tournament, but it does affect your confidence. And you could see it, the way they played yesterday, how close they were last week in those two disappointing losses, the outstanding team effort yesterday, and you're getting that again here tonight. It's a confident group. They're just getting more. Oh, man, he hit another guy. All right, that's the fourth bit batter of this ball game, and it extends the inning, and you don't, you definitely don't want to do that.
Now we're going to make another change here.
Let's see. Ralphie's coming out of the dugout. Is he going to go to the pen now? Remember, he had 79 pitches coming into this inning. And Lucky is warming up down in the pen. Is he going to make the move just yet? We'll see. Ralphie wants to do here, but he's brought in the entire infield.
Well, you got the number eight hitter coming up.
You got the eight and nine guys.
KE2 and a pop-up.
Yeah.
And so, you know, I think if you're coach, I think you're just telling him, listen, Michael, rear back and throw the strikes, throw the fastball. All right, we'll pop the curve when we need to get it, but you got to break it, and that's part of the problem. I think he leaves him in there.
I think he's leaving him in too, Judd. I think he wants to just settle him down here. Yeah. This is number one guy here on senior night.
Is this a pinch hitter for Westminster? Number six coming up?
Yeah. That would be Greg Penton. So Penton's going to come off the bench here.
Pinch hitting, number six, Greg.
And he will hit for Luis Mejia. Christian Mejia is on deck for the Warriors. Right here. Greg Penton, he's a big guy, bats from the right-hand side. And he'll await the pitch. Big swing and miss, strike one.
And he's going downtown with that swing.
So Michael trying to work around two hit batters here. Remember, there are two away, and they've got the tying run at second. So right now, Hawks clinging to this 2-1 lead. The 0-1.
Yes.
Good look at that.
Oh, my
goodness.
Get
the call. Fastball looked like it painted the outside portion of the plate, but I mean, right there, but doesn't get the call. The count is 1-1. Swing and a miss. Strike two.
All right, Michael, here we go.
One ball, two strikes, two outs, two on. Hawks leading 2-1 here. Huge moment in this ball game. The 1-2.
See ya!
And a miss. He'll strike him out. His 11th strikeout of the ball game. And Alfonso will leave the tying and go-ahead runs out on the base paths. For the Warriors, no runs on no hits. There were no errors and two left. We'll head to the bottom of the sixth. It's still Key West 2. Westminster Christian 1, back in 90 seconds here on your home of Hawks. The Zone, 97.7 WABQ.
Shout out tonight to our baseball sponsors. They include Gary the Carpenter, the Compound, Ron Russo, Zelch Accounting, the Hurricane Hole, Mathesis, Martin Construction of the Keys, J.W. Martins. Key West High School Baseball is grateful for our baseball sponsors. Leading over the Conks in the bottom half of the sixth inning, third baseman number 10, Preston Hurst.
All right, here we go into the bottom of the sixth. See if the Conks can add a couple of insurance runs here as Key West leads 2-1. Preston Hurst looks at the first pitch from Joel Pinheiro. It's in there for strike one. The second offering just misses a bit outside, and the count's at 1-1. So Preston, followed by Jaden Birchfield and Trevor Zelch, the 4, 5, and 6 guys for Key West. Preston 1-for-1 today. And he just put a charge into this one. Deep out in left field, going back and making a catch out there. How did he do that? What a play by Christian Mejia. As that ball is hit deep out into the gap in left field, Mejia turns and runs, and I thought he lost
it. He turned to his right, then he turned back to his left and somehow put his glove up there and got the ball.
And forward toward the fence and somehow made the catch. Holy cow. Wow. What a great catch.
Yep.
Rob's Preston of extra bases, and there's one away. At least a double. Well, if that got by him, that's the fence. He's a third. You know,
easily at third.
So a great catch. We've seen two big ones here by both teams out in left field. Ann and Rady just moments ago had a really nice catch for the Cons. This time Mejia does it for the Warriors. That pitch missed wildly outside. Ball one to Birchfield. He got on board when he got hit by a pitch in his last at bat. The pitch is in there for a strike in the fourth. Scored a run. His first at bat, back in the first inning, he hit it hard right on the screws, but right at the shortstop as he lined out. So officially, he's 0 for 1. The 1-1. And therefore, strike. And I haven't mentioned it yet tonight, Joe. I need to. Remember, if the Hawks hit a home run, that's a Tavern in Town home run dinger.
You gave one away yesterday.
I did. I was very excited to do that. First person that could get to Judd and me here in the Todd Swafford Broadcast Pavilion. Receive a $50 gift certificate to Tavern in Town. That one swung on and fouled out of play. And the count remains at 1-2. So one away here. The ball is swung on and grounded down to Stewart at third. Double pumps a couple of times, but he's got a very strong arm, and he's able to beat Birchfield to the bag, so now two down.
Yeah, nice pick by the first baseman on that one, though, too. Right?
A little low, yeah. Ortiz does a good job of going down there and picking it up and getting the out. So there's two away here for Trevor Zelch. Laid down a beautiful sack bunt in the fourth. 0 for 1 as he grounded out the second in the second. But Trevor tonight had one huge defensive play where he turned a big double play. Couldn't check a swing on that low pitch for strike one. Half-hearted cut. Spinero trying to get through the sixth inning. Throwing 77 pitches through five. This ball is down the third baseline by the diving third baseman. It should be extra bases for Zelch. He's got to hustle down to the bag. Safe!
Yep.
Wow! Mejia was on it quickly. He had a good throw into second. But Zelch is able to slide underneath the tag for a double.
Yeah. The second baseman had to field the ball on the left field side and was not able to get the tag around.
And the ball hopped up too, Judd. So with that hop, he was able to slide underneath the tag, and he was safe. And good hustle there. Sixth hit of the game.
Let's see what they're going to do here.
For the Conks. This is Wyatt Coon's spot. Should be in and Rady batting in that spot, and it is. And Rady looks at this one for ball one. So Andon, who just came up with a huge defensive play, let's see if he could do it with the stick here, batting 146 on the season. He's just a youngster. He'll be here for a while. Right now, we'd love a hit. The 1-0, not even close. Going outside, ball two. And it's batting where Wyatt was. And Wyatt got injured running up the first base line in the fourth inning. He picked up an RBI with an infield single and tweaked something going up the line. This ball is hit hard, and that's through the hole between third and short. Are they going to send Zelch? Here he comes. Here's the throw home. It's offline. He's safe, safe, safe. Hey, hey. Andon Rady off the bench with a huge catch in left field. Now a big RBI single, and the Conks get an insurance run and lead 3-1.
And Rady just took that fastball, drilled it between short and third. Left fielder comes up throwing, but a great slide away from the base, just getting his hand on there, is Zelch to give the call.
Hey, two great slides that time by Trevor Zelch, and Ralph Enriquez Jr. never hesitated in sending him home, and he's able to score. Here's Nate Barroso. He'll swing at this pitch and foul it out of play for strike one. That was RBI number 9 on the year for Andon. Whew. Another fun one, the 0-1. Inside, ball one. Hawks looking for their second win in a row here in what the skipper is calling rivalry week. Yesterday against Gulliver, win 5-3. Right now have a 2-run lead, 3-1 over the Warriors. Let's not stop now here. There are two away. There goes the runner. The pitch missed for a ball. And again, no one covering the bag. Not either the shortstop or the second baseman. And Rady easily steals the bag and no throw from Melendez.
And, you know, great job by the catcher not to throw it. He was up ready to fire, and, you know, for him to be able to hold back.
Yeah. That's the second time that's happened in the game. And Rady's in scoring position with his fourth stolen base of the season. The 1-1. Sails a bit high, ball two.
3-1.
Pardon me, 3-1.
Yep, 31 right now.
Jaden Melendez, the catcher, comes out, wants to have a word with their starter. Joel Pinheiro working into the sixth, but the Conks have been able to pick up key run here. Started with the double from Zelch, and he's able to come home on the big single off the bat of Andon Rady. Great defense, clutch hitting again for the second game in a row for Key West. The 3-1, swung on.
That's a foul. Ooh, somebody's hit.
Is it the catcher's helmet?
Yeah. Catcher or the umpire, one or the other. I think it was had to be the catcher because he heard that plunk.
Yeah. With that hard plastic.
I think the umpire might have gone down if that had crunched his head.
Count runs full here to Nate Barroso. He's 1-for-2 today. It was Nate who laid down the suicide squeeze back in the fourth inning. Scoreboard was wrong.
Yeah. I have ball four.
Okay. It is ball four. Okay. I was wrong. Ball four.
Now batting for the Conks, your shortstop.
He'll walk him. That's a third walk issued by Pinheiro, and that this may be it for him. Let's see what Westminster Christian wants to do here. Is they'll head out to the mound, their skipper, and talk with his starter, and he's tapping him on the chest. Let's see what we do here. They're gonna make a move.
Yeah, we had 77 coming into this inning.
Yeah. So Pinheiro's night is done here as the Conks will chase him out of the ballgame here in the sixth inning. Key West has added an extra insurance run, lead 3-1. But still, we could get some more here with runners at first and a second here at the bottom of the sixth inning with two outs. Let's give the new pitcher time to warm up as we got a pitching change being delivered by Domino's Pizza. Domino's didn't stop the pizza, and you don't have to either. Give Domino's a call at 305-296-7795 for pickup or delivery. Hey, get the door. It's Domino's. While the new pitcher warms up, let's take that 90-second break. Back after this here at home of the Conks, the Zone, 97.7.
Pitching for the Warriors. Coming in from left field, it is number 18, Christian Mahega.
Christian Mejia is going to come in from left field and take over for their starter, Joel Pinheiro. Look not closed on Pinheiro as the runners on the base paths wouldn't charge to him if they're able to come home and score.
This is the Raleigh Fingers guy.
Yeah, he's got the submarine action.
Yes, he does. Dennis Eckersley.
Mejia getting his warm-up tosses in here. Conks leading 3-1 here. There are two away in our bottom of the sixth inning. We got Andon Rady at second, Nate Barroso over at first after he just walked. So bring Mejia in. Let's see here. Mejia is 1-1 on the year with an ERA of 0.71. Worked 19 and two-third innings. He's allowed 11 hits, 4 runs, 2 have been earned, 19 walks, 18 strikeouts. He's been out in left field. Now he's on the hill. And he will face Kai Smith. Kai 0 for 2 today at the plate. And he just got hit.
Well, we'll load the bases.
So the bases are loaded for Key West. Rady moves to third. Barroso now at second. Mejia comes in and immediately hits a bat. That's the second time Conk has been plunked here today. Pinheiro went 5 2/3, 7 hits, 5 Ks, 3 walks, 1 hit batter. He threw 96 pitches. Now you're back to the top of the order. Here's Logan Pellicer. He's 1 for 2 today. He also worked out a walk. Comes up now with the bases juiced. Need some more here, Jeff.
Yeah, Logan needs to have some patience. So he's a first ball swinger. He needs to calm down and relax and let him see a strike.
He out of that submarine action gets him to chop down to second, or short, excuse me, to Ramirez, who fields it, goes to second for the force out, and score at 6-4 on the put out, and the inning will come to a close. But the Conks are able to pick up a valuable insurance run on 2 hits. There were no errors, and we left the bases loaded. We played 6. It's Key West 3, Westminster Christian 1. Don't you dare go anywhere. We're back in 90 seconds for the 7th inning between the Conks and Warriors here on the Zone, 97.7 WAVK.
For your Conks in the bottom half of the 6th inning, there's 1 run. Three hits, no errors, 3 runners left on base. We have played 3 innings. The score, Key West 3, Westminster 1.
For the Warriors in the top half of the 7th inning, hitting for Christian Mejia is number 19, Peter Frometta.
All right, here we go. The Conks 3 outs away from a huge win over Westminster Christian. Key West leads 3-1. Michael Alfonso stays out on the hill and delivers the first pitch to Christian Mejia, who's now the pitcher in this ballgame for the Warriors for strike 1. Alfonso wasting no time. The second offering in there, strike two. So Mejia bats in the nine hole, then it's back to the top of the order and the big bats, Sal Stewart, Jaden Melendez, due to bat for the Warriors. Michael quickly coming home here. This ball's chopped foul right at the plate and the count remains. No balls and two strikes. Michael has held the Warriors to just one run on only two hits. He has struck out 11 and walked two. He's worked around four hit batters. Their only run is when they had that extra out that they had in the third inning.
See ya!
Swing and a miss.
Let's make it a does, cuz.
That's now 12 strikeouts, an even dozen for Alfonso. Now Ralph Enriquez working in front, coming out in front of the dugout. And he's running out. Boy, Ralphie, boy, he's out there. He is directing the outfield. He's like a conductor at an orchestra right now. As the big guy, Sal Stewart, with all those home runs, digs in there and takes a hack, strike one. Stewart came into this ball game batting 548 with 11 home runs. And he has just ripped one deep out there in right field. Will the ballpark hold it? No, it's gone. It's a solo home run for Sal Stewart. We held him down for the first three times. We struck him out, intentionally walked him. He got hit by a pitch, but this time he goes the other way, not to the deepest part of right field, but to the left of the foul pole line. It stays fair and just gets out of here.
But like you said, solo shot. If you're going to give up one, give up a solo one, baby.
Right. Honk's got that extra run there in the bottom of the sixth, so it's key right now as it's a 3-2 ball game with one down. And that's what happened last night, Judd,
right,
up at Gulliver. They had a solo home run in the bottom of the seventh inning, and it didn't affect the ball game because if you're going to give up a home run, do it with nobody on the base paths.
Yep.
You still got a one-run lead. We got two outs to go here. Here's Jaden Melendez. In there for strike one. For Stewart, that was his 12th home run of the year and his 26th RBI. Pitch is in there, strike two. Hawks leading 3-2 here. The pitch, there's the breaking ball and he didn't chase. And I think that's it, here comes the skipper. I had him at 96 coming into this inning.
That would be 105 right there. Mm-hmm.
And another outstanding effort by Michael Alfonso. And the senior get a nice round of applause.
Ladies,
a big crowd here at the Rex, and his teammates are coming out, high-fiving him here. As he goes six and a third here today, and now it'll be up to Lucky Barroso and the pen to nail down a save here. Hawks are two outs away from potentially getting this big win here. So let's give Lucky time to warm up as this pitching change is being delivered by Domino's Pizza. Domino's didn't stop at pizza, and you don't have to either. Give Domino's a call at 305-296-7595 for pickup or delivery. Hey, get the door. It's Domino's. While Lucky warms up, we'll take that 90-second break. We're back in 90 seconds here on your home of the Cons, The Zone, 97.7 WABK.
shortstop number one, Rene Ramirez.
Okay, we're back here. Lucky Barroso finished up his warm-up tosses pretty quickly. He took over the count 1-2 to Jaden Melendez, who then swings at a pitch and into the hole at shortstop. And Kai Smith couldn't come up with it, and he's charged with an error as the tying run is on board over at third base. At the plate is Rennie Ramirez. He's 1-for-3 today, and he's got the count at 1-1-1. So Barroso trying to nail down the save here. This pitch a little bit low, ball two, as he took over for Michael Alfonso. For Lucky, 0-2 on the year with a record of, with a record of 0-2, an ERA of 5.33 in 21 innings of work. This ball is ripped back to Barroso. He fires over to second for one. Pass!
Hey, hey! Game over! 1-6-3, double play. Ends the ball game. And the Cogs have won two in a row and knock off the powerhouse Westminster Christian here today, 3-2. How about that?
What a great job. Lucky fielded that, fired right over to the shortstop. Kai made a great throw.
Well, what a play, what a job by Kai Smith, Judd, as that ball kind of sailed on him as Lucky spun and fired it a bit high. Kai went up and got it and then got the throw back to Zelch for the second double play of this ball game. Big double play that the Conks turned, and they're going to win this game by the final score of 3-2. For the Warriors here in the seventh, they picked up a run on one hit. That hit was a solo home run. Nobody was on board when Sal Stewart took it out of the park, but it wasn't enough to catch up. And then the big double play. So one run on one hit, no errors, nobody left on base. Conks win. Final score, 3-2, as they pick up their seventh win of the year. Wow, what a ball game here tonight at the Rex. Hey, don't go away. When we come back, we'll get the Mojo's Sports Bar and Bistro post-game show started. We will wrap up this ball game. We'll hand out some awards, and we'll get you set for next week. Conks win over Westminster Christian by the final score of 3-2. Back in 2 minutes right here on your home of the Conks, The Zone, 97.7 WAUK.